Bismillah, wassalatu wassalam, assalamu alaikum everyone. I hope you are doing well this weekend, inshallah. I just want to share something that we covered in one of our lessons yesterday. We were studying arguably one of the most important works on tafsir by none other than Imam Razi, his book on tafsir of the Quran, the Mafatih al-Ghayb. And we were looking at the discussion around seeking refuge with God. And in the book, Imam Razi has a discussion around the seeker, the one who is seeking refuge, the musta'eez. And he begins by saying something very, very interesting. I want to share this with you because it shows that when a person seeks refuge with God, knowing that nobody can help them, in reality, nobody can assist them, nobody can benefit them, no one can harm them unless God wishes it to happen. And in return, Allah always gives me and you something in return. When we turn with sincerity, with humility, and we turn to our Creator, then in return, we will always get something of a gift, something in return for it. And so he begins, and this is what's called al-Rukn al-Thalis min Arkan hadha al-Bab. He says, al-Musta'eez, in terms of seeking refuge. When you say, a'udhu, I seek refuge, this is a Umar, this is a order from Allah to his slave. أن يقول ذلك وهذا غير مختصم بشخص معين. It's not for one specific group of people. فهو أمر على سبيل العموم. Like everybody should say أعوذ بالله. Everybody should seek refuge with God. And he says, look, even God in the Quran gives examples of prophets seeking refuge with him. لأنه تعالى حكى ذلك عن الأنبياء والأولياء. That pious people and the prophets, even they sought refuge with their creator. وَذَٰلِكَ يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّ كُلَّ مَخْلُوقٍ يَجِبُ أَن يَكُونَ مُسْتَعِيذًا بِاللَّهِ. So from this, we know that every creation of God should always seek refuge with him. Fine, we're okay with that. And now it's really interesting because I'm going to go through some examples where he mentions that in the Quran, this prophet sought refuge, and look what Allah gave him. Look what God gave him. So it's فَالْأَوَّلِ أَنَّهُ تَعَالَى أَنْحَكَ عَنْ نُوحٍ. God mentions about the Prophet Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam when he says in the Quran, وَهُوَ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى قِيلَ يَا نُوحُ بِدْ بِسَلَامٍ مِنَّا وَبَرَكَاتٍ عَلَيْكَ. Yeah, that when Nuh, when he said that I seek refuge with you, when Noah, the Prophet Noah, sought refuge with God, God gave him two gifts. Right? What did God give him? He gave him salama, he gave him safety, and he gave him blessings, right? That he came down from the ark. He was saved. The ark was a gift for him, right? Because he sought refuge with God. So God gave him this ark to save himself and people and animals that joined him, right? That was a gift from God because he turned to God and he recognized that nobody can help him, nobody can harm him, nobody can benefit him except when and God wishes, right? So that was something very, very interesting to see in the example of the Prophet Nuh, or Noah, may Allah's peace be upon him, right? And then the second example he gives is about Joseph, Yusuf. And he says, and Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, أن المرأة لما راودته قال معاذ الله إنه أحسن مثواي. That when that woman tried to seduce him, Allah says in the Quran, what did he say? I seek refuge with God, right? He's my master and he will make my residence good. Right, so what did Allah give him in return? So Allah fa'ata Allahu ta'ala khil'atayn, right? Allah gave him two gifts. Allah gave him two gifts by deflecting the evil and shameful deeds from him, right? And so evil was turned away from him. That was a gift. The fact that evil is taken away from you or you're protected from evil is a gift from God. And also from shamefulness, right? Because we know that, well, maybe not today, because nowadays modesty and humility is somehow not seen as something to be celebrated. But in many societies, being chaste, being a person who's dignified, who's known to be moral, was something of a great gift to have, right? To be known to be a person who's upstanding, who doesn't engage in immorality, of truthfulness, of justice, and these sort of attributes were very much known. So the fact that he sought refuge with God, God gave him this gift, that he became known for these things as well. And then Allah continues, he actually says, when he says to Allah, and when it was said to him, peace Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam, that take one of us in his place, right? He said, I seek refuge of Allah from taking anyone other than him whom we found our property. So Allah honored Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam again, and he raised his parents high on the throne of dignity, right? His parents were given dignity. That's a gift from God. The fact that Yusuf sought refuge with God as well, and they fell down in prostration all before the Prophet Yusuf. The third example is of Moses, peace be upon him. So Allah talks about Yusuf, and then Allah also gives the example of Musa. Haqqallahu Musa alayhi salatu wasalam annahu lamma amara qawmahu bizabhi al-baqara qala qawmu ittakhadahu huzwan qala a'udhu billahi an akuna min al-jahilin. Right, that when Moses, peace be upon him, instructed his people to slaughter a heifer, right? They said, are you mocking us? Right? And he said, I seek refuge from being an ignorant person. So he sought refuge with God. Then Imam Razi says, فَعَطَ اللَّهُ خِلْعَتَيْنِ. God gave him two gifts. خِلْعَتَيْنِ, two gifts. That the first one was that any negation of accusation against Moses, right? And the second one was that the bringing of the dead to life as well, right? Allah says in the Quran, فَقُلْنَا ضْرِبُوهُ بِبَعْدِهَا كَذَلِكَ يُحْيِي اللَّهُ الْمَوْتَى وَيُرِيكُمْ آيَاتِهِ. So the point here again and again, Imam Razi is saying, look, in the Quran, we're seeing this, that people who take refuge, seek refuge with their creator, right? They are being given gifts. They are being protected. They are being given gifts by God as well. Then he gives an example that when his community of Moses were fearful, or they were threatened by Pharaoh, right? He said, وَإِنِّي عُذْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ أَن تَرْجُمُونَ. Again, he's turning to his creator. And he says, I have sought refuge with my Lord and your Lord against you injuring me, you causing harm to me, right? And in another verse, Allah says in the Quran, إِنِّي عُذْتُ بِرَبِّي وَرَبِّكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مُتَكَبِّرٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِيَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ. That I have indeed called upon my Lord and your Lord for protection from every arrogant one who believes not in the day of judgment. So what did Allah give? فَعَطَى اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Allah gave him his wish, مُرَادَهُ, and Allah destroyed his enemy. Allah destroyed his enemy and caused his people, the people of Moses, to inherit their lands and homes. So again, we're seeing this idea, when you turn with complete conviction to your creator and know that nobody else can give you protection, nobody can save you, nobody can harm you, nobody can benefit you except the one creator, then you are given benefit. Then you are given these gifts by God. Imam Razi is bringing these examples out time and time again. He gives an example of the mother of Mary. when Umm Maryam, when she says, وَإِنِّي أُعِيذُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Right? And so when she said, I commend her and her offspring to your protection from the accursed or the rejected Satan, right? And so what happened? She received a gift of her acceptance, of the acceptance. And Allah says in the Quran, فَتَقَبَّلَهَا رَبُّهَا بِقَبُولٍ حَسَنًا وَأَنْبَتَهَا نَبَاتٍ حَسَنًا. That her Lord accepted her gracious favor. He made her grow in purity and beauty. Allah gave her this because she turned to him, right? That her purity increased, her nobility increased, her beauty increased because of the fact that she turned to her creator. Another one is the example of Mary. May peace be upon her as well, right? When she saw the angel Gabriel, Jibreel, peace be upon him, in her solitude, when she was approaching solitude and she saw the angel in his human form, right? And what did she say when she saw him? She said, قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيَّا. Right? That, and this is so powerful because she's a woman who is chaste. And what did she say? I seek refuge from you with the compassionate. Come not near if you do indeed fear God. If you do indeed fear God, don't come near me. And what happened? She was given two, فَوَجَدَتْ نِعْمَتَيْنِ. Allah gave her two gifts, right? Waladan, Allah gave her a father, a son without a father. Allah gave her a son without a father. And then second thing was God declared her blamelessness, right, upon the tongue of that very son. When, for example, he says in the Quran, Inni Abdullah, that I am indeed a servant of God as well. So this is found in the Quran. I'll just give you one more example of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, when God instructed him to seek refuge time and time again. When Allah says in the Quran, وَقُلْ رَبِّ أَعُوذَ بِكَ مِنْ هَمَزَاتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ وَأَعُوذَ بِكَ رَبِّ أَنْ يَحْضُرُونَ, that, oh my Lord, I seek refuge with you from the suggestion of the devils, and I seek refuge with you, oh my Lord, lest they should come near me. Right? And so again, you know, he's turning to God, and you see these examples. And he says right at the end, Imam Razi says right at the end, فَهَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ دَالَّةٌ عَلَى أَنَّ الْأَنْبِيَاءَ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامُ كَانُوا أَبَنًا فِي الْإِسْتِعَادَةِ مِنْ شَرِّ الشَّيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِ, that you see that the prophets, God's peace be upon all of them, were constantly seeking refuge from the evil of humans, but also from the evil of the spirit devils. So that's that in the Mafatih al-Ghayb, worth reading. I thought I'd just share that with you. You can find that here. You can also find the English in Dr. Suhaib's book as well, which I recommend everybody gets a copy of. The particular discussion that we have had in this book is on page 110 to 111. I hope you found that useful and beneficial. That was just something that we covered yesterday amongst many of the gems that we were covering yesterday in one of our lessons with some students and people of knowledge. Until next time, stay safe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi.